And welcome to the channel. My name is Annalisa, and today I am doing my mermaid piece. As I've been going through some of the things from my old house that were hurt by smoke and looking at them and deciding whether to keep them or not, I found one that I got at an event called Art in the Park a few years ago. It was a painting of a tuxedo cat who was staring at a little Tinkerbell, and I really liked it, and I have been wanting to replace some of the art that was more destroyed than this one was, and I've been wanting to support some more artists by getting my walls covered again. Along with this painting was a little card that said fairyprints.com, so apparently this artist puts their work online. And so I went to the website and I found a lot of pieces that I really liked. And one thing that a lot of the pieces had in common was that they were pictures of fairies, mermaids, magical creatures like that. And they were usually multiple in one shot, so there'd be a couple of fairies together, maybe a mom and baby fairy, or three mermaids sitting together, or four magical people walking along together. And it made me remember how much I would like to find myself in people's paintings and find like my groups of friends. So like it would be really cool if there was a painting of four fairies walking along and they all had the same sort of hair colors and heights of a group of friends that somebody had. So that reminded me of how much I liked that idea. And so that inspired me to make this piece, which is a mermaid version of me and my mom sitting together. I decided to go with mermaids, partially because this is mermaid and I wanted to do a mermaid piece, but also because I've only done one mermaid piece in the past and I really liked it, but I wanted to do more and have it be better than the last time. And the rest of the inspiration came from the fact that it was going to be Mother's Day soon, and I like to make my own cards for Mother's Day, Valentine's Day, and all that. So I decided this would be a good thing to do for my mom as a gift. And so I wanted to do something that would be kind of a picture of what we like to do together, or what our kind of thing we bond over is. And so we both really like to read. We like to read different books. There's also a certain book series that we both read, and that is the In Death series by J.D. Robb. And we also both read some of the other books written by Nora Roberts. And we like to talk about them and how much we love the characters. We also went on a trip to England a while ago, and Ireland. A little bit of Scotland and a little bit of Wales, too. And while we were in Scotland, we really enjoyed seeing some of the places that were described in some of our books. But other than both of us enjoying reading, we are also just generally best friends. We have a lot of other interests in common, and we like to spend a lot of time together. And we're both a little bit odd in the way we relate to other people, me more so, but, and we're both just not very social, so most of our close ties are with family members. And of our family, we are the most similar, so we end up talking about a lot of stuff together. We also like to watch sci-fi together and other shows, like we watch all the Star Treks and a lot of murder shows like Bones and NCIS, and then we also watch West Wing together, which is a lot of fun. We've just recently been going through Midsummer Murders, which we got recommended from my cousin and aunt, who are also good friends with each other and now with us too. And we've been enjoying that a lot. So I kind of wanted to represent our friendship here in this piece together for Mother's Day. So, on to about the actual painting, how I made this piece. One thing is, I've noticed since I've been trying to be kind of loose with my work, I've really enjoyed these sort of bullet-shaped
paintbrushes that are kind of fat. Oh, we've come to the section where Arwen interrupted. I had to push her off. She did that a couple of times. Both kittens really like to be involved in what I'm doing. Here's another clip of they were going around and around me on my chair under my desk and then around behind my back. So I decided to capture some of what was going on there. Okay, so since I'm at that part, I'll tell you I used some of the glittery dust paint I got from Violet Connie Art. And so I used the blue, what was that? Fairy dust on my mom's tail because she's got a bluer tail. Her favorite colors are blue and purple, and particularly a color between blue and purple called periwinkle. And so I gave her a blue, purple, green shirt there and a blue and green tail. So I used the bluer sparkles on her tail, and then for me, I wanted to be wearing pink, so I gave myself some green, different colors of green scales to kind of contrast with the pink and make it pop a little bit. I also used some of the blue fairy dust to just go over the background very lightly. Before the part where you saw me making the rocks, I went over the entire piece of paper with a very thin layer of that pixie dust, and so now when I turn the page in the light, the scales that I picked out with the pixie dust or fairy dust, I laid it on very thick, so those shine very bright. But then there's also a little bit of sparkle in the entire background, and I really like how that looks. And now, of course, I'm putting on the freckles on both of us. We're both very freckly. My mom has blue eyes and red hair, red curly hair, and lots of freckles, and she passed on the blue eyes and the freckles to me. And then I've got my straight brown hair from my dad. But my skin is all my mom's. And then I'm adding some little, I wanted to have kind of more fancy, magical looking clothes on us, so I decided to do that with the sleeves because I didn't want us to have very much sleeves because it's like a summer sort of picture. We're like ready to jump in the water at any time, so they're kind of like sleeveless or only slight sleeves kind of stuff you could wear into the water. So I decided for sleeves to give us these little drippy droppy things that are like beads on little strings coming off. And then you can see me filling in the eyes. And once again, this is one of the pieces that I decided to do all of the watercolors first and then do the line work because I found that that seems to give me, it seems to make it more of a piece that sort of flows off the end of my brush and just makes it more of a watercolor painting, a whole watercolor composition rather than just being some line work that I filled in with watercolors. So it makes me a lot more free to make shapes with my watercolors and make them look that kind of way. And so then I would go over with a little liner afterwards, although this does of course lead to occasionally me putting the lines in the wrong place, which you'll see I did a little bit of on the cup and then on my mom's back there, I had to get rid of that line later because I put it in the wrong place. And then with my tail, I went a bit over funny in the wrong way, so I fixed that later with more watercolors. But I do like the overall effect of doing the line work after. Also, when I would do the line work beforehand, when I put the watercolors over the top, it kind of dulled it down, so the black wasn't as present there, so the lines weren't as didn't stand out as well. So I found that I really like how it looks when I put the line work on afterward. Plus, I've also gotten some more compliments in some of my pieces I do that with, than the ones that I start out with line work and end with filling in with watercolor. So that is my mermaid piece. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!